In this video, I'm going to show you how you can easily root your dragon fruit trimmings and grow yourself another dragon fruit plant just like this one. So guys, welcome back to Greenthumb's Garden and another video. My name's Alex, and if this is your first time here and you love gardening videos, horticulture, plant care and DIY, then make sure you hit that subscribe button, hit the bell notification so you don't miss a single thing. So the only thing we're going to need for this, obviously, is some dragon fruit cuttings. We're looking for ones that are nice and healthy, remember, nice and plump as well, full of life, and no signs of disease and rot, maybe fungus as well. We want to start off with the most healthy piece we can. These are all right. This guy's a bit skinny, but we'll deal with it. We're also going to need some supports that's going to prop up our dragon fruit cuttings while they develop a nice strong root. I'm using a nice bit of bamboo cane that I've managed to get hold of, and I've just sliced it down the middle, so I've got twice as many because it doesn't need to be that strong. They're not very big. And by the time our dragon fruits grow and they're ready to be planted into a bigger pot, well, we'll be using bigger supports by that time. Anyway, we'll also obviously need a little bit of string to tie our segments to them supports. So grab a pot. You hear the helicopters, they're still trying to die that giant wildfire out that's been raging for the last 4 days. It's been the biggest wildfire to hit Andalusia to date. So grab a pot and add some potting soil to it. Buy yourself a good, decent potting soil. And if you've got access to sand, then add about 20% sand to the mix. That'll help improve the drainage. If you haven't got access to sand, don't worry. Good potting soil should be quite aerated and be a nice mix anyway. But I find it's nice to add a little bit extra sand. It is a cactus at the end of the day, and that'll make a nice potting mix for cactuses. I've also added a fair bit of my compost from my compost bin. Dragon fruits love soils rich in organic matter. It'll help with water retention also. So once you've got your pot sorted out, we just need to plop our dragon fruit in just like that, about an inch and a half. We're just taking it up to there. We're not bothering, if you've noticed, to snip the ends. Many will snip the ends about here and then allow that to dry. You can do that, it's a technique, it works well. I've used it before and the cuttings have grown quite well, but you don't need to do that. You can just plant them just like they are. Once the ends have dried here, just pop them in like that and they'll just do just fine. So once we've got him in the pot, we'll stick our stake in like that. We're not putting him deep in, eh? About an inch and a half. Then we want to take our string and we're just going to tie him to his support. Just like that. Nice. Let's get him to the side. We'll do another one. So grab another one of your cuttings and we're just sticking him in just a little bit. Just like that, very little. And then we'll add a stake. That's gonna keep him from toppling over. Then we're just gonna add a little bit of string to tie him to his support, keep him nice and steady. Just like that, really nice. And that's basically it. That's all there is to it. So we're gonna give these now a gentle watering and keep them quite moist in a semi-shaded area where they'll not be exposed to too bright and hot temperatures, because don't forget, they have no roots and they can't take really hot temperatures and hot days as our established plants can. So we're going to keep them in the corner down there, and it'll probably take about a month, maybe 2 months, before we start seeing any signs of growth. Next week I'll be shooting the video for our cherry tree, the third update, and answering some of the common questions that's being asked. We'll be talking about also some of the problems and the dramas that they've been through. I look forward to sharing them videos with you guys. As always, it's been a pleasure. If you enjoyed the video, hit that like. It really helps the channel out. It helps the YouTube algorithm as well. Share this video with your friends or any of the videos you think that they'll enjoy. It'll help the channel get more exposure. That's the best support that I could ask for. Guys, it's always been a pleasure to catch up with you guys. There's going to be a Venus flytrap video coming out soon. Remember that tiny little Venus flytrap? Well, it's doing well, and we're going to have to pick a winner as well. So that video, I'm going to try and shoot that one next week as well, and a few other things. Guys, as always, I look forward to talking to you again, and I'll see you later.